So the next process is what we've done here, we've set the room out. So basically we've got, we found the straightest wall. Obviously it's an old house, so you're not really going to get them too straight, but this has come out very good. So we do, we measure from one side to the other, then we centralise it, so half it, and then we ping a line down the centre here. Can you see my blue line? Just down here. And then basically what we do is we glue the room out, and then basically that's when we can start fitting our tiles. We let the glue go off. This is F46, which is pressure sensitive glue. And what that does, that allows, if there's any movement in the floor, the tile can move with the glue. The glue always stays active.
Oh,
so, yeah. Yeah, so it pretty much you put a bit of heat on it and then it reactivates the glue. So
okay.
It's probably the best glue on the market, this is. Yeah, so what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to finish off gluing this out. So, I'm using all the figure of eight. And with this glue, this is a V5 notch, this is, which is a 1.5 mil we're using.
Okay.
It's a V5 1.5 mil notch for that. This particular one's made by Genesis.
Okay, I'll add all this to the video so we can give them a nice list of the products and tools we're using here.
Yeah. So now basically what we'll do is we just wait for this glue. So as you can see, the glue's white now. So what will happen, in about 20 minutes time, it will go translucent. So it'll go from white to translucent.
Okay.
And then what we do, that's when we can start fitting
the tiles. That's when it's ready, is it? Yep.
I mean, you can fit it a little bit before, but you don't want it too wet because your tiles will start sliding about on the glue.
So you're saying you've measured out, you've done half the room?
So basically what we've done, you go from that skirt in to say this wall behind you,
yeah,
in this room. So that will give you the centre of the room.
Yeah.
Generally the centre of the room, the tiles will always meet and leave you what we call wallies. We don't want no wallies, which is basically little slivers that go down the sides of the wall.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, because they're hard to put in.
Yeah.
They're awkward. It's just not nice. So what you want to do, you want to leave maybe half a tile to a quarter of a tile on each cut of life. And it's dropped in perfectly here as well. So that's what basically.
Okay, we'll see that in progress a bit later then. Yeah. Okay, good.
So these are our tiles we're going to start putting down now. So generally I like to start, well it's not a big area, so we can start sort of there. As long as your tiles are staggered. So then what we do, so here's our first cut. So what we do is what we call a double cut method. So we put, so we get the first tile, stick it on top of the other one, then get another tile, and then we stick it to the wall like so. See now that doesn't look straight, does it, on there? But what that does, that's taking the contour of the wall. So we'll get an accurate cut. So there. Bring your tile over. Get your tile. Bend it. Break it. And we get our tile. Hold it like so. Make sure it's nice and flush. And then in you go. And there's your first tiling. There you go.
Nice.
Then all you do, you just repeat the process. So, say for instance, then you want to put one there. Side. So. So once you, the first tile you use for the cutting, see there's glue residue on it. Try not to keep using different tiles, because otherwise you'd end up with red glue residue on all your tiles, and you might stuff sticks to it, etc, etc. So then we just come this side like so. Drop it in like that. I mean, you can use a straight blade. We tend to use concave, what we call a concave blade. Salvage edge at the back here.
What's a salvage edge?
So when the tiles fall, we call these are salvage edges. So once it's cut, it's a raw edge. So it'd be like it'd be a bit bitty and whatnot, and it mightn't be straight. The salvage edge is always straight.
Right.
Yeah. And then what we do is we come across here like so. So nice and tight. And again. Cross with your knife. So I just use my hand, but what you can do to get if it's slightly off because the skirting's not straight, yeah. What you can do, and it's off the tile.
Yes.
So what we do is we get another tile, butt it there.
Oh, I see. Just so and then you can
so you don't
line.
Yeah, so yeah. You can do it. But I obviously
you can do it by eye, yeah.
Because it's all this is a cut edge. So obviously there's a little bit of a lip here, so this just goes in. So. Yeah. So. Again, cut in like this. So what we're doing, I'm just randomly placing the tiles. So we've got nice staggers, yeah? So they're all staggered.
Yeah.
So you don't want them all uniformed.
No, no.
Starting from. Yeah. So. So as you can see here, now you can feel that it's a lot more rougher than the salvage edge, because the salvage edge is smooth. So that's when you know, and again, to utilise tiles. What I'm going to do here, first of all, we get the length cut. So what we do is put it under there like that. So cut across there like so. So what that's done now, so let's give us the exact right cut for here, yeah? So what we do then, we put that there. Stevie back. There's again. A little bit of tie here. Oh, that fits straight.
That doesn't it?
It's perfect, look at that! Oh, damn it. Oh, I've never had that happen to me before. It's a first for everything, I think, isn't it?
What are you looking for, Hughie? A bit of contrast?
Yeah. Yeah, so you don't want them all to be too similar. Just slightly overcut that. Okay.
can see there's a gap there. There is. You just turn it like that. Smaller bit of tile. At least on this side, because we've got a notch out there. If you wish. I've heated it. Obviously we can't take these plugs out because of the internet. So we need to put a notch down each side, like so. And then very gently, because we're wiring now, we just nip that bit away. And then again, very, 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 very gently come across here.
Oh. Very neat.
And then that sits in like that.
Yeah. There we have it. That's our side cuts. So as you can see, look, there's near enough a full tile in there. So that's what you want. You don't want like small slivers like that. Or that. I mean, even that's all right, not too bad, but you want them as big as possible on the sides.
Yes.
You don't want any small, which is what we call wallies then. You have to piece bits in, because what can happen, they start to tip, they start to pop out. So, that's the reason when we set out, we leave ourselves a nice bit of tile to cut into.
This half's nearly done then.
Pretty much, yeah. So we've got tile here now. And then we just repeat the process again.